everyone. I got a lot of requests for an explanation of how the automated LEGO Train call terminal works, and I've made two videos which explain the functional design of it. In this video, I'll explain the unload procedure. If you want to know more about the layout, passenger trains, and loading procedure, click the link below for the other video. Alright, let's unload some coal. From the coal train yard, a full coal train is enabled and directed to the unload terminal, which is controlled by the main controller. The system waits until the train arrives, and once the train arrives, it hits a sensor and the train is stopped immediately. This is a very precise action since the hatches in the bottom of the wagons must line up with the unloading conveyors. And because of this, all three coal trains have the same length. Once the train has arrived, the sign is put to red and the pneumatic switch is flipped. As a result of this, the pneumatic pistons under the rails and wagons are extracted. The pistons push an electrical conductor to another electrical conductor on the bottom of the wagon. This makes an electrical connection between the motors in the coal wagon and the system. So the sign is put to red, the pneumatic switch is flipped and the pistons extract. Here you see a 3D image of a coal wagon. As you can see, the wagon has a motor, linear actuator and a hatch. When the motor is activated, the hatch will be opened or closed depending on the turning direction of the motor. The blue strip on the bottom represents a piece of old 12-volt train conductor. This conductor is connected with the motor. All three wagons are unloaded at the same time. The coal falls on three different conveyors and the coal from the first two wagons is transported to another conveyor which transports the coal to a silo. This is the silo that we've seen before in this video. The coal from the third wagon is transported to a buffer. A Technic excavator moves the coal from the buffer to a second silo. This excavator is moved by three NXT motors and a few linear actuators and a pneumatic piston for the bucket. I've used the pneumatic piston for the bucket because it only has to be in two positions, so the control of it is less complex. The pneumatic piston that moves the bucket works with a different air pressure than the other pneumatic systems in the terminal. To reduce the air pressure, the air feed line to the excavator is passed through a pressure reducer. The pressure of the whole pneumatic system in the terminal is regulated by a compressor that keeps the pressure stable between 35 and 40 psi. So this is how the coal trains are unloaded. If you want to find out how the wagons are loaded, click the first link. This will lead you to the video which explains the loading of the wagons and the layout. If you haven't seen the Phil's video of the coal terminal yet, I'd recommend that one too. There are some hilarious shots in it. Thanks for watching. Bye.